Hey guys, this is Ronaldo Maya 999. I'm here with another The Walking Dead, of course, season one. Last time we played A New Day. The stats. I was honest to Herschel, because why not? I saved Duck, even though for most of you, from what I heard, is he's useless. He's still a child. So shut up. I defended Kenny, because he's a cool guy. I did not give the gun. That is... And I saved Carly, because... Well, actually, I don't remember why. You have to watch last time's episode. But who cares right now? Right now is episode 2. So let's play episode 2. I'll just be quiet for this moment.
Previously on The Walking Dead.
I know who you are.
I got another good one for you.
Stupid driver. Exactly. Fuck you, Larry. All right, now I'm ready to kick this. What's wrong with the audio? Can you hear me? What's going on with the audio? I'm actually quite curious. Beeping noise. Let me see if I can fix it.
Damn it. What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Well, that's another meal lost. I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
Rabbits.
Thank you, the Exotic Gamer 4.
We're all hungry.
Those of you on YouTube, is someone in Twitch.
When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was gonna take off my hand.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left.
Yeah, we'll manage.
We'll manage.
Maybe. You know, some people aren't too happy about the way Lily's handling rations.
Lily knows it's important to keep the adults fed and functioning. Sometimes that means someone's gotta miss a meal.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time, things are getting pretty tense back at the motor inn. You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
Kenny's a good guy. He won't abandon us.
Kenny won't abandon us. He's a good man.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night? What's the old guy's deal, anyway? Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
I'm gonna choose the old racist ass.
He's just an old racist asshole. That's his deal.
Well, he needs to get over that and start finding a way to pull his weight. Heart problems or not, we should all be out here trying to find food. And I know Lily thinks he's getting weaker, but the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver. I know I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one time?
knock me flat.
Nah, don't risk the noise. The last thing we need is more.
Don't. Gunshot will bring walkers. One bird's not worth it.
Yeah, I know. I'm just really frickin' hungry.
Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from that.
What guys? Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
What happened?
I don't know, man.
What the hell happened?
Mr. Parker said we should stay off the streets. We were trying to be careful, but... Lee, this is fucked up. We've gotta help. Please!
Ben, shut up! My dad was Special Forces. I know what I'm doing!
Just see if you can get him out! After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care! Please!
We have to try.
We gotta get him out of there!
Oh, God, thank you!
Fine, but you gotta hurry.
Hurry, please, hurry!
Lee, this trap has been altered. There's no release latch.
Okay, I may not be someone with,
oh no,
hunting stuff, but who doesn't have a freaking
shit? Walkers! It's now or never, Lee!
Please! Get me out of this!
Mark, get the boys back! Kenny, keep those walkers off of me!
Please hurry!
Please!
Do something!
Get me out!
Is he gonna make it? Come on, do something!
Oh, yeah!
Hurry!
You stand like that at the Air Force Base to lift ordnance. You're not cutting through that.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Gotta get the chain!
Come on. I already did, you stupid idiot.
Please! Oh, I was moving like this!
Stop!
Fuck. Let's go! Let's go!
I'm sorry, pal, but we're gonna have to.
It has to be now!
No, no, no! Try the trap again! Anything, please!
I'm sorry, pal. This is gonna be horrible.
Damn it, Lee!
But I'll save
your life! You don't have time for that! I'm sorry, but we have to go! Now!
I'm sorry, Kenny.
Lee, I can't keep him back forever!
I'm doing my best here. Just one more might do it.
Fuck, I'm just wasting ammo now. We gotta go.
Wait, oh, Kenny, God, let me try one more. We cut him free.
Oh, God.
Shit. Is he?
He passed out.
If he's alive, grab him and let's go.
Behind you!
Travis! Oh,
come on, come on, we gotta move! No!
Why am I not surprised?
Thank you. Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on, come on!
Oh my god! What happened?
What the hell?
What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat,
okay?
Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken!
Lee!
I don't know.
Lee!
What?
What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking
hey,
minute?
No, I don't. I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
I thought we could save his life. I'm the one that took his leg. That makes me responsible.
Well, that was a stupid thing to do.
We
Shut
are
up.
Not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group, right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be helpful.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine. You guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know, you like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions. This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Oh, come on, you're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not gonna be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around, but now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
Kenny's right. Yeah, you're in charge of the food and the schedules, but you're not in charge of people's lives.
Really?
You weren't there. Lee made a choice. End of story.
Look, once Katja patches that guy up, you can kick him out of here. Send him out on their own. I couldn't care less. But they at least deserve a fighting chance against the walkers. And for the record, Kenny wanted to leave those people behind.
If Kenny would pull his head out of his ass for 5 seconds, he'd realize that I make these decisions to protect his family. We simply don't have enough food.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
F you, Larry.
Dad, please. Why don't you go help Mark with the wall? You know what? If you think I'm doing such a shitty job, then you do it.
I'll do a better job than you.
That's all the food we have for today. You decide who gets to eat.
Lip.
No, I'm serious. Pick up that food and start handing it out. You see how it feels to not have enough food for everyone.
For 10 hungry people. Katja first.
Here, eat something.
Why don't you give it to Doc? I'm a little busy with your mess right now.
Jerk.
Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure.
Sure. What do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg.
Blame it on Kenny. Nah, I did the right thing.
I did the right thing.
Yeah, I know you did. The right thing is just scary sometimes, I guess. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help. Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little space here anyway.
Okay. Alright, I want y'all to comment below. Who would you feed? There's Lily, Carly, or / Doug, depending on who you saved. Because I know you have to feed him eventually. Clementine, Duck, Kenny, Ben, Larry the
Will you hold the damn
Larry
board
the
steady?
Card.
I'm trying. I didn't realize
Mark.
I was getting this weak already.
Actually, we'd like
what
to know.
What do you want? A handout?
And yourself.
I got 60 cents in my pocket. If you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
See, that's why I'm not going to feed him. F you, Larry. You're not going to get fed.
Hey, you holding up okay, Lee? I was pretty fucked up back there, having to cut that guy's leg off.
Yeah, I just hope Katja can save him. You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Listen, I know her intentions are good, but...
But nothing! She's making the smart choice. Those parasites you guys brought back need to go.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. Do you mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Oh, ha ha ha. Like I'm gonna give it to Larry. You know, I'm just gonna say this. If you give the axe to Larry, I feel pity for you.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry. Give it a rest, man. Things are different. Being a racist is outdated.
Oh, and that's what you think this is?
Yes.
Is that what you told him?
Yeah, that's what I told him. Wait, where's the... There it is.
Yeah, that's right.
And what are you gonna do about it?
Look, I don't care what it is, but you two have got to start trying to get along.
The only thing I have to do is protect my daughter. And right now, that means getting this damn wall fixed. So I would appreciate it if you two would shut up and let me get back to work.
Mark, you're a cool guy, but because you did that, that just penalizes you that I'm not giving you food anymore. You just ruined it for yourself. And I'm not talking to Larry at all. Now. Oh, dang.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
You have to be a complete asshole to say no.
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Now first is feeding Clem, because she's special. Not in a bad way, she's this character that
hey,
I would
Clem,
want to take
you
care
need
of.
Something to eat.
Half an apple. Keep her healthy.
I love apples. Thank you.
Boom.
Are there more?
No, honey. That was the last one.
Oh.
Enjoy it. You deserve it.
We need Carly. She was cool. But first, let's talk to Clementine.
That thing doesn't work anymore, does it?
No, not since it broke at the drugstore.
Just gonna hold on to it then?
Yeah, if that's okay. I need it.
It's okay, hon.
You said you didn't think they would find us.
Well, yeah, but that's just because...
But we can try to find them.
Look, Clementine.
I'm not stupid, Lee. I know it's just pretend. But it makes me feel better.
Okay, you take good care of it then.
I will.
How you doing, Clementine? Everything all right?
Yeah. Is that man going to be okay?
He'll be fine.
I think he'll be fine.
Oh, that's good.
All right, let's talk to Carly.
Lily has me handing out the food.
Listen to this, guys.
Ugh, that can't be an easy job.
It's not. I won't be able to feed everyone. What should I do?
Well, if you wanted to get in good with Lily, I'd make sure Larry gets some food. Even though that guy can be a real dick sometimes. On the other hand, giving that food to Kenny and his family might make him remember you if he decides to take off in that RV one day.
What about you? You need food too.
We all need food. I can't tell you what to do, but whatever happens, I know you'll be trying to do the right thing.
Thank you, Carly.
Thanks, Carly.
Because of that, you earn yourself to eat food.
Want something to eat?
Piece of jerky.
Here.
Me? How about you? You look like crap, Lee. When was the last time you ate?
I'm okay.
I want you to have this, okay? In case you or Clementine starts feeling weak. I know I said it didn't matter why you saved me instead of Doug, but...
You don't owe me anything, Carly.
I'm going to feed Duck.
You were pretty brave when we brought those people in here.
That's because I know Mom can fix him.
How you doing, Duck?
I'm okay. Me and Clementine are coloring.
Guess what it is?
I don't know. A dog?
Nope.
Oh, I know. It's a goat, right?
No.
I don't even.
Hey, Duck. How about a little food? Here.
Yeah! Oh man, I'm so hungry!
Duck and his family appreciate that. Alright, I'm gonna go talk to Kenny now. I need to speak with this guy.
Word's getting out that you want to leave the motor in.
That ain't no secret, Lee. It's probably our best bet. Look, you've been good to me and my family. You saved Duck from those monsters, and you stood up to Larry at the drugstore. I won't forget that. You and Clem are welcome to come with us.
Thank you, Kenny. Yeah, I'll click X, because it is a good idea to go to the coast.
The coast does sound like a smart idea. Maybe that is the best thing.
I know that it is. I'm taking my family.
All right, let's feed this guy. He's been nice to us. I'll give him a piece of jerky.
Here, Kenny, take this.
How about my boy? He eat yet?
Yeah, I gave him something.
Sure, then hand it over. I'm starved. Thanks.
Nope, I think someone else deserves this. I think I could have my own strength.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
Alright, I'm gonna say this. Those of you that have a complaint who I gave the food, you better comment
How's it
below
going,
and
Lee?
I'll...
From up here, it looks like you're playing favorites.
F you, Lily. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah, if you have a problem with who I chose, you can comment it below. I'm gonna comment back and come back at you. Just a thought. Now let's talk to Ben.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way.
Either that or leave him.
How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
You did all you could.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
Who are you?
So who are you people? Our group's gonna wanna know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The man you saved is Mr. Parker, the band director at my school. We all came down from Stone Mountain for the playoffs when everything happened.
Nah, you deserve food.
Want something to eat?
This is probably gonna cost me a lot, but I don't care. He's a good kid.
If your camp got raided, probably means you haven't eaten in a while.
I am really hungry. Thanks.
Not such an easy job, is it?
Nope. Oh, don't give me that. You screwed it up for me. Shut up.
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Hey, thanks for looking out for me and my family.
I'm serious about that offer to come with us. You've more than earned a ride on the RV with me. Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
You're out! What happened to my food?
There's none left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
You're one to talk, old man.
Yeah? Well, I don't see you working on that wall.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Kaja.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
Nope. You ain't killing her.
The axe!
That's why I actually am happy you don't get through. You messed that up. No. Get away.
Shoot it!
You okay?
Yeah. Thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word!
But he wasn't bitten, I swear!
Well, your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What? Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
God help us.
It makes sense. In those first few days, it spread so fast.
Car accidents, suicides, everything was making more of them.
When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
You're outnumbered here.
You're outnumbered here. Just turn around and go back.
Okay, that's fine. But you'd really be helping out a fellow survivor if you could part with some extra gas before we leave.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
Nah, I don't trust you guys.
I think we'll stay here. We're starting to develop a good vibe here at the motel.
Good vibe? Well, Christ, Daddy-O, I'm sorry the folks with the food supply and defenses didn't tickle your pretty pink ass.
Shut up, Larry. You're a...
We need to think like a group, Lee. This affects everyone.
Then we vote. If everyone agrees, then we'll send you guys with some gas to check the place out.
And if we don't?
Then we'll stay in this wretched roach motel with your recreational paperweight over there. Plus, we stay close to Macon where we have access to the pharmacy for Dad. Kenny, Katja?
We go.
Damn you.
Dad?
You betcha, Pumpkin.
Carly?
I said we go.
I'm in. If they're offering food, we gotta at least check it out.
Oh, great. My choice doesn't matter.
Clementine, what do you think?
Lee, I'm very hungry.
But I fed you. Right.
Looks like we're going to a dairy.
Dang it.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
Me as a leader?
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
And I'm the best leader in the world.
Everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Stupid Larry knows.
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore. Asked me about it. I couldn't lie to her.
What exactly did happen with the senator?
I actually don't know, so I'm just going to say it was an accident.
It was an accident. I mean, I pretty much knew about the affair. Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
Yeah, I do, too.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
I'm sorry, but I have to say the truth.
I am. You guys have any questions? You come to me.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Enough.
Enough to defend ourselves.
Well, that's good. It's getting dangerous out there. Well, you guys know. Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for, well, as long as I can remember, but now it's getting...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always
fucking
pulling this shit.
Bandits.
Who?
Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you. You knew we were hungry, and you guys were keeping it all to yourself.
There's only two of them.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and you know what? We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens, but let's just wait this out. Hope they move on.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jesus!
Asshole.
The world out here has gone to shit. Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe. Here it is, St. John's Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
Huh. I'm just gonna say this is actually a brilliant setup. I'm not gonna lie.
This is a really brilliant setup.
Suits us just fine.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Gosh, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
I would say I've got things under control, but we all work together.
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place.
Hold on, I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh, yeah, I thought she was asking about survival tactics.
Well, it don't matter. You're here now. We'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
We're awful hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she?
We have a vet. We could bring her here.
Mark!
We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh, my! Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come.
No.
For the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend, and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Before I choose anything, Mark, are you a dummy? We don't know these people. I don't trust them at all. I just don't trust them. Not because they're... No, I was going to say something that was going to kill me. No, let's just make sure this place is safe, just because you're an idiot.
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right, I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
All right, let's move.
So what have you found out? Is this looking like a good place to stay?
I'll keep looking around.
All right, keep me posted.
Hey, what are you fixing to do around the barn?
Just trying to help, since I can't really say what I'm doing.
Just trying to find more ways to help out.
Well, I appreciate that. Tell you what, we'll find you something to do over there after we get back from securing the perimeter.
Sounds good. What's that?
Generator. You guys come along with gas just in time. Hey, don't mess with that, okay? The thing's a little tricky, and I don't want to spend half a day trying to fix it again.
What if I want to be a douchebag and do that? That'd be funny. No, that would be cruel, even for me.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. You've been stockpiling, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If anyone tries to fuck with us, they'll regret it.
Well, protecting your people is important, but in my experience, having that many guns around is when people get dangerous.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots, and we gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
Interesting.
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
I'm gonna get to know the place for a minute.
Okay, well, we gotta secure the perimeter, so don't take too long.
I'll bet they go through a lot of wood keeping those fences repaired.
Well, let's see. Look at the swing.
Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I can imagine.
I'll bet. Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope. Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. John's know we can pull our weight around here.
Let's go up here. I want to check the inside of the house. Aww. This place looks amazing. I'm not gonna lie. Okay.
What happened to the rest of your staff?
Oh, we've had our share of tragedy here. Just like everyone else, I'm sure. Some of our staff took off to find their family as soon as they heard the news. The few that stuck around, well, we lost most of them the first night those things showed up here. It was a tough night.
How many rooms does this house have?
Rooms? Why do you ask?
I can't say that. Just curious, that would be too... I got an idea.
It looks custom built.
Nice of you to notice.
Oh, it is?
My husband put a lot of work into this old house.
Well, he did a fantastic job.
I believe in making a house a home.
When will dinner be ready?
It'd be a while still, but it'd be worth it. Trust me.
How's your family been holding up since, you know?
All my boys have been my saving grace. They both left their jobs and came home to help out after the attack started happening. I think it was hardest on Andy. Dan was always more of a mama's boy. But don't tell him I said that.
Well, if anything comes up that I can help with, feel free to let me know.
Well, Lee, I sure appreciate it.
No problem.
Screw you, game. I wanted to enter the house.
This rope is perfect for the swing. This dairy won a lot of ribbons in its day, huh?
This place was my daddy's life. Meant everything to him. You know, when he first bought this place, it was a single-story house.
Is that right?
After us kids was born, he insisted on adding a second floor. Said they had to have room for as many babies as they could have. Mama, she was done after Dan.
My folks stopped after two as well.
Then one day, the world changed. Now this place is all we have left of Daddy. That's why we take such good care of it, and why we want to share it with good folks like yourselves.
All I wanted to comment in that whole conversation was, where the hell did you come from? He just came out of nowhere. All right, let's talk to Mark. Tell him what we found out.
Hey. I didn't get a chance to check out the barn area yet. I'll do that after helping Andy get the perimeter secured.
Then?
Generator might be a problem. Andy said it's tricky and repairing it takes him a while. Still, it's a hell of a lot more secure than the motor in. I'll keep looking around.
All right, keep me posted.
Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
Time to fix the swing.
All right, this shouldn't be too tough.
Well, I'll be damned. Mama's gonna be thrilled to see that old swing all fixed up.
Hopefully our kids will like it too.
Did you say something, darling?
Alright, you know what? I think I've wasted enough time. Time to go inspect the fence.
Ah, Bailey!
No, down. Get off! Here. Go away.
It's overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
So how's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
Why the hell did you have to tell him I thought he was a racist? As if tensions weren't high enough.
Yeah, you stupid Mark.
Sorry, man, it popped out.
I mean,
you did admit it right to his face.
Well, he deserved it. No, I'm gonna say what I really think.
That guy's a piece of shit anyway.
Relax. You're not making things any better riling him up. There's one.
Since the guy that I told... that said that it was racist.
Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Huh.
Come on, let's push it off.
Andy said when this fence is working, the walkers go up like a tree branch on a power line. If those lights are out, that means the fence is off, right?
It better be. Disgusting.
Who do you think he was?
At least not one of us.
At least it's not one of us. Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
A fortress needs people to defend it.
We've got enough people. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
We've got enough people to take this place by force if we have to.
Sheesh, Lee. You sound like Kenny.
There's another one.
Because Kenny's my friend.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Would have been nice to get some of those rations. I get hungry too, you know.
Focus on the task. Dude, I told you the reason why I didn't give you food.
Just try to focus on the task.
They knew what they were doing, teasing us with food and then giving us chores.
Having a good meal will be worth it.
Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea. If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on. Little help here, Lee?
All right.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on!
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
No, he didn't. Great.
What the?
Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole!
Jesus!
Oh, that's just great.
Now you fuck!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out!
Give it
Stop shooting at us! Don't mean you any harm, goddammit!
You didn't deliver the goods! Now we're gonna take one too!
Oh, shoot.
Try to lure me to Yelvin! Don't think I can't see ya!
Alright.
If we can reach the gate, we can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah!
They're on the
Shit,
move.
That hurts!
Ow, fuck you, dumb bitches! Get closer! Got one of you.
Oh, dang.
Now there you are, boy!
What happened?
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier.
Wait a minute. No. That looks nothing like the one we pushed earlier.
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Only two?
Get closer! It ain't rat!
Away! Away!
Show yourself!
And we break it out.
You okay?
Yeah. Barely.
Come on. The gate's right there.
You fuck with us. Take what we want. I got one of you.
Screw you.
Let's get out of here.
You lucky sons of bitches. Go ahead and run. We ain't going nowhere.
I thought this place was safe.
Holy shit, are you okay?
Fucking bandits. They have no right being out here.
Oh, my lord. What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my god, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh no, honey, come on, Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
Christ, maybe you were right about this place, Lee.
Yeah.
So much for your deal.
Those shitheads broke the agreement. Look, I'm sorry, Lee. If I had any inkling they were going to give you guys trouble, well, we would have gone out there with you. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor inn until we get back.
Hey, kids, look what Lee got working for you.
A swing. I love swings, just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc. Thanks, Lee. You're the best.
Yeah.
No wonder you're the leader of your group.
In front of everyone. Okay. I wonder if Lily's gonna call me out for that. Let me talk to Kenny. Oh, right.
Hey.
Hey, Lee. Found anything interesting?
I'm just trying to make sure this place is secure, in case we decide to make this a more long-term solution. Except for those people in the woods. Seems pretty safe.
Good to know. Keep your ears open for anything else that might help us.
Hmm.
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here?
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you got a pretty clear head about these things. Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
Well, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
I hope you're right. Duck and Clementine deserve a better life than starving to death at some crappy motel.
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, right. Cold sweats.
M1
I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
I don't know
yeah,
how to pronounce it.
I'm not
name.
Just talking about one meal, you know?
Midnight?
I'm gonna go have a look
okay,
around.
Thank you.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the
game.
St. John's and their relationship
okay.
with those
just
bandits or whatever.
Comment what
right.
is your...
I'll see what I can find out.
What would be your... Wait, hold up. I messed that up. Give me a second to rethink. Which one's your favorite episode, then?
Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
No,
yeah,
wait, hold up.
It's fun. Thanks
Bailey?
For fixing
down.
It.
You're welcome.
Will you push me on it?
Sure.
Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
Don't worry. We're safe here now.
As long as the bad people don't get me all right.
I'll remember that when I get to the fourth episode, my friend.
Promise?
I promise. What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
Don't know yet. By episode 5, I'll know. I'll make sure I give everyone a good decision.
Yeah.
I mean,
not
a good
sure when.
Opinion of which one was my favorite.
Things have got to get back to normal.
That's good. I hope it's soon.
Yeah, me too. How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You got lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Well, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
All right, Clem. That's enough for now.
Okay. Thanks for pushing me.
Of course. It's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck. Don't pop a gasket.
All right. Time to actually go to this camp and get rid of the thing.
Fellas.
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, it'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Are you going now?
Yeah. I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
Aw, Clem.
See anything?
Not yet.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close. Oh shit, you found it?
Huh. Slowly, carefully, sneak into this creepy camp.
You see anybody?
Stay on your guard.
Stay on your guard.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent. Too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Empty. Nothing.
What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
Not unless you need empty cans.
Not unless you need a bunch of empty cans.
I'll pass.
Exactly.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line. What'd you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Why?
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get
moving. Suspicious.
I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily? I thought you were running things back there.
Yeah, but she's got the combat training.
Yeah, because I'm not a fighter. I just protect people. You know what? I want to look in the tent. Bailey?
Oh, man.
Sorry. Sorry guys for that noise, it's just Bailey messing around with the mic.
The hell?
Don't move! Shit!
Put your guns down.
I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal.
What happened
you
here?
People broke it first.
Why are you alone up here? What happened to you?
Well, that's a hell of a question, mister. They told me I'd be safe with them. Men who lived here. But it weren't safe. Not for me. Not for my girl. They didn't treat her nice. Not at all. They took her away into the woods. Wouldn't tell me where. And I begged them every way I could think. They just laughed. So I killed them. And I'm staying here till she comes back to me. One way or another. She'll come back. Now maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down. You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball and into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters.
No.
Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her.
So what if I did? You stole her from me.
That's illogic.
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Put down the crossbow.
No, sir, I need it. I need it to kill you fuckers. Go on. Tell him, boy. Tell him what you got in mind for...
Okay, I don't know if you guys would shoot her, but I didn't. But that was just brutal.
God damn it!
You murdered that woman.
You straight up murdered that woman!
Hardly. She had a crossbow pointed at my forehead.
No.
It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message. Come on.
Well, I don't know what to say. Whether sorry you care for that woman or not, she wasn't done talking. And that, I would want to know what she wanted to say.
Man, that was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are ya? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back! What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
All right, Midnight. I guess you did a good choice there.
Don't know. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
Don't mind Kenny and Lily. They just can't agree.
They have different ideas about how we should run our group. If they don't find any common ground, this whole thing's gonna fall apart.
No, it's just tough times. Everyone's hungry and people get a little stir-crazy when their tummy's empty. And Lee, don't worry your head about them
okay,
bandits.
Midnight.
I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
All right, I'm gonna go talk to Clementine. I forgot, I have to give her her hat. There she is. Look, a cow.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katya says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
Clementine. Here, have your hat
here,
back.
Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I actually don't know what to say to for Lee. For me, I'd press Y.
I do someday. Maybe a little girl like you.
That's nice. You'd be a good daddy. Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead.
Huh. I wonder what this door does.
You found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff. Something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
I'll protect her no matter what.
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. Look, that guy with Katya. What's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
Yeah, all Kenny. Right, Professor, don't overdo what you have it. In mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee, you know how to pick a lock, right?
No. Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban.
What the fuck, Kenny?
You are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry.
Oh, that's gonna penalize you, Kenny, for that.
What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right, sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
Kenny thought he heard a noise.
He's a little jumpy, huh? Well, we're all sure glad his wife is here. She's a lifesaver. You got no idea. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
No,
hey,
no.
Guys, seriously, don't fuck around with that. Come on, enough already.
I didn't click the A, that's the thing. What the heck?
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Why do you lock that door?
Because we can't afford to lose our shit to the people in the woods. They come down here every once in a while and raid our stuff, even with the fence.
I can imagine why.
You got a screwdriver?
For what?
Never mind. Danny mentioned he needed something.
Did he say what?
Shit, I can't remember now. Sorry.
All right. Be right back, Doc.
Ah, look.
How are the kids?
They're doing okay. I never did thank you for saving Duck from the walkers back at Herschel's farm.
Katya.
Andy will be back any minute. Please hurry.
I don't know if Katya knows what we're doing or no. All right, let's do this.
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
Okay, new plan.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
Before anything, I need a screwdriver. And I remember seeing a toolbox. So...
just gonna borrow this for a second.
All right, now let's mess with this thing. Turn it off. And let's go.
thing is the worst piece of shit. Something's always tripping the breaker.
Aww. Well, that happened. Anyone want to comment on that? You know what, just for fun, I'm just gonna do it one more time. Troll him.
Again?
Oh, I just gotta love doing that to him. Alright, now seriousness, I actually have to get rid of him. Alright. Midnight, since you know what's gonna happen next, any strategies for me without spoiling it? If you're watching. Those on YouTube, this is me, Twitch, talking to the Twitch people, not YouTube people. Just clarifying that.
There, that should do it.
Fucking Danny, where'd he find this piece of shit? Oh, fucking thing threw a belt. Damn it, Tom. Ah, oh, son of a fuck. Oh, this take forever.
You know what? You just... sorry. You just got trolled. Oh, okay. I'm noticing that it just changed, the day changed, the setting. Let's talk to Kenny and alert him that we're ready.
I picked up something I think could help with the lock.
Nothing to stop you now.
Let's go.
Mom, Dad, dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Sure thing. Okay, I know I didn't trust him in the beginning of the episode. Now I definitely
Boy,
don't.
Didn't you hear the bell?
Now I definitely don't even trust him at all.
Dinner time.
I'm just gonna lie to him on this one.
Look, I just came in and found the door open like that.
Probably my idiot brother. Hey, was anyone with you just now?
No.
Not the doc?
No, she went in the house.
Oh, good. Yeah, good.
I do not trust you.
Brenda, you are an angel.
Excuse a mess. We had to block the back door after a walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. Now go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
Nope, I'm getting at it. I'm gonna check what's going on. I do not trust them, and I must tell Mark I don't trust them. Shut up. Hey, look, a cord.
What the hell? Where the hell is Mark? But Brenda said he was up here resting.
Oh God, you psychopaths, what have you done to my friend Mark?
Lee.
Mark, what the hell happened?
Brothers.
I knew it, we shouldn't have come. And y'all didn't listen. You're stupid.
Don't eat dinner.
Oh, obviously, they're cannibals. Kill them! No, she's gonna eat it. Yes. Move. Move, your stupid ass. I ain't letting her eat this. Move. She hasn't eaten it yet. Clementine.
No!
Lee, Jesus, man. Did you find something? Aw, oh, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He could use some goddamn manners.
It didn't have to be this way.
Shut up,
Danny. This woman right here is fucking insane!
This woman made you a home-cooked meal, you ungrateful shit. Show some respect.
Thank you, Larry.
You don't even have the decency to take a handout when you're offered one. It just makes me sick. It really does.
That's enough, Larry.
You know what?
Maybe
you,
we
Larry.
Should...
Hang on, Cat. Just keep Duck close.
You know what? Fuck you, Larry. Eat up.
I will, and I'll enjoy every last bite.
Yes, eat up. Wait till you find out what it is.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
They're picking us off to trade as meat.
You're out of your skull.
Mark is upstairs right now with no legs. Brenda. Tell me he's not being eaten right now.
I'm putting you on the table.
It's true.
You crazy.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Fuck you.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
We outnumber you.
Lee, that's not a very nice thing to imply.
You are crazy.
Andy is right. Bitch. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
Like y'all.
Oh, like hell. Kenny, get your
gun! Kenny, get your gun!
Kenny, no!
Nobody's going anywhere!
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking what?
Put your guns down! We're walking out of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Everyone, everything will be okay!
Lee? Lee?
Oh, now you're gonna die for that.
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!
Oh, I'm gonna remember this, Andy. I'm gonna remember kicking your ass left once I get through with you.
Please! Someone!
Dan, you're screwed too. All of you are screwed.
Open the goddamn door! You can't keep us in here! Open up! I will tear you fuckers apart with my bare hands!
We gotta find another way out of here!
You shit fucking bastards! Open this door, goddammit! I will knock the goddamn door down!
It was a person. They tried to make us eat a person.
But you didn't do it.
No.
The rest of us did, goddammit! If you hadn't dragged your feet...
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
That evil fucker invited me to eat the meat. And all the time, he knew what it was.
Stay calm, Dad. We'll deal with it later.
That's what you get, asshole.
Is there a way out?
Yeah! Through this fucking door!
If they so much as touch my family, I'll kill those sons of bitches!
They locked us in here. I think it's a meat locker.
Those psychos have caught you in dirt!
Open up! You sons of bitches!
Dad! Please stop!
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
You're worse than the walker!
Don't give
Dad,
up.
Please.
We're gonna find a way out of here.
Can I help?
Sure, honey. You keep your eyes open for exposed screws or loose panels. Anything we can pry away to open a passage out of here.
Okay.
Please, I better calm this guy before he gets us killed.
Come on, Larry. Do you really want to attract their attention?
Yeah, I want to attract their attention so I can fucking kill them!
Guess your new girlfriend wasn't all she was cracked up to be.
What the hell is your problem? You refused to give me my day's rations back at the motor lodge. And you practically fucking pushed my face into that goddamn human barbecue? You must really hate me. But guess what? You're stuck with me. I plan to be around long after you're gone. And if you turn, I'll be the one to put the axe through your skull.
Dad!
I'm not your enemy, Larry.
I don't believe you. Don't forget, I know who you really are. Come on, try yourself, fucking cowards!
Dad!
They got caught you in duck, Lee. Those fuckers have my family.
I know. We're gonna get out of here and find them.
There's more of us on the way. Let us out now.
Your dad's not making things any easier for us.
Open Baby. The fucking
Dad,
door!
Dad, stop!
God damn it!
They're not gonna open the
hey, look.
Door.
In a ventilation, air conditioner.
Gives you the right... I'll break that damn door down!
Dad,
like
you can't get... Easy!
Oh, God.
Dad?
Oh, great.
No! Dad, come on! Dad! Oh, God, he stopped breathing. I think he's had a heart attack.
Shit.
I had to. Midnight.
He's not dead.
He was a jerk.
Somebody
he deserved
help
me. It.
If he's dead.
He's not dead.
It has to happen, Lee. Think about it. You saw that poor bastard at the motel? How fast he turned?
What are you saying?
Lily, I'm sorry. I truly, truly am.
Oh, no.
But in a few minutes, we're going to be stuck in a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
We'll mourn him later. But right now, we have to keep him from coming back.
No! God damn it, Kenny! He's not dead!
Lily can still save him.
I wish she could. Believe me, I do. But that man is dead. You both know what happens next.
Look, Kenny, back at the drugstore when we all thought Duck was bitten. I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we should do the same now.
That was different. Duck wasn't bitten. Come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said.
Kenny.
Gotta destroy the brain.
Don't.
Come on, Lee, I'm right about this. I know you've got my back. You always do.
God damn it, Lee, I need you! Please help me!
Come on, Dad. Come on.
Oh. Fuck me.
Wake up!
Okay, I'm pausing this for a moment. Hold up. Hold the fucking phone. Alright. Do I help Kenny kill Larry because it could be possible he comes back? Or do I try saving Larry, which means helping Lily, despite my friendship with Kenny? Damn it. Motherfucking choice. Last time I had some kind of a crazy decision like this, I chose wrong by accident. So I'm gonna... Ah, fuck me. Alright, I'm gonna give y'all a moment. Don't pause. Kill him. I'm sorry, YouTube, you can't see this. Exotic Gamer Phone, kill him. Oh, God. I'm sorry. Alright. This is the decision because this is who I am.
Come on!
Lee! Is he breathing at all?
No!
I can't kill
a
dead man.
Okay, let me take over.
He had a heart attack.
Are you stupid? He's gonna turn! You're putting all of us at risk, you son of a bitch! You're fucking worthless.
Look, I saw his mouth move. Motherfucker.
No!
Kenny, I'm sorry.
What the fuck?
I'm so sorry.
It had to be done.
You don't know that!
Yes, I do, Lee. And so do you. I was counting on you, man.
I'm sorry. I know.
Don't you fucking touch me!
I'm not an evil person. I won't just kill out of hate.
Are you okay?
And plus, he just had a heart attack. It wasn't gonna kill him. Not yet. I have to be honest.
Not yet. We still have to find a way out of here.
I'm sorry, Clem. You have to see this.
I know. But you gotta be strong right now. I need you to be strong. Think about something else. Something hopeful.
Like what?
Okay, Twitch, YouTube, I guess.
How about you walk it?
Did I do the right choice?
Those pretend talks with your mom and dad.
Why?
Don't those make you feel better?
Sometimes. We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it.
Stupid Kenny.
I don't want to hear it, Lee. You think I like doing what I did? I'm the guy who couldn't bear to watch the family dog get put down. But if we want to survive this shit, we gotta have the balls to do the hard thing. Or at least one of us has got to.
You talk a big game, but could you do the hard thing if it was Katja or Duck?
It's never gonna come to that. Not if I have anything to do with it.
For all we know, the St. John's might have...
No! They need Katja, remember? She's the whole reason they brought us here. And no doubt they're using Duck as a bargaining chip.
I hope you're right.
I know I'm right. I just gotta get to him, that's all.
Okay. Okay, alright. Shit, you decided... wait, you should have killed him because you hate him and... No, I never said I don't like Lily. I mean, she's mean, but she's just... I just love how you all are mad at me. It's just funny.
He was still alive, Lee. He was still alive.
I mean, she's sympathetic. Larry was... I mean, he was a good father to her, I guess.
Sorry, Lily. I truly am. Larry and me, we might not have got along so great, but I know he would have done anything to protect you. Was a good father.
You spelled liar wrong. You know that, right?
There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
I'm sorry, YouTube. You just can't see it. Oh, Kenny, shut up.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Of course they took it. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use. I've got a rock.
A rock won't help, but a coin might do the trick. Do you have a coin?
Good point. You got a point there, Mike. But at least she's more sympathetic, right? Well, she's pissed because her father's dead. Even though, Exotic Gamer. Yeah, there's a block on his head. All right, Kenny. Listen up.
Gonna survive this shit, we got to work together. How do you expect Lily to work with us after what she just saw you do?
If she wants to live, she'll work with us. If she doesn't, then the hell with her.
I don't think so. Punching something like that will break. Alright.
Listen, I need a coin or something. It's important. It could get us out of here.
Well, I got nothing.
Yeah, Kenny, because you're useless right now.
Please, I need to be alone.
God knows you deserve time to grieve, Lily. But if we're going to get out of here, we need your help. And Larry's. I think I may have found a way out of here, but I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something.
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Oh, God, this is gonna be horrible.
Oh, boy. Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
All right, guys. Let's see if I get the right pocket.
Here we go.
Oh, I actually got it in the first try.
And a dime.
Okay, that is quite funny in a way, because I got it in the first try.
Look. Just gotta remove these screws and get this unit off.
What the fuck is
that? Hurry the fuck up, Lee. We don't have all day.
Hey, shut up, Kenny. I have this. Wait, it's not a gamer. I don't know what you're trying to comment. There's so much going on.
There's our way out, Lee.
Yeah. Huh. It's too small.
Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
It's too small for us to fit through.
I can do it.
You don't have to do this, you know, Clementine.
You know you don't have to do this, right?
I know. I just want to go home.
This'll help us get
Why do I want the blessing? Because it's her father's, and just looting it around could probably tick her off.
You're gonna be fine.
What do I do when I get out?
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
Hey, Midnight Gamer, anything else? I mean, Midnight, anything else that I should know? The block on his head did not see that, like, coming. What? I've sided with you for the entire episode one, and most
Lily,
of this episode, so
I'm
shut
sorry.
Up.
We gotta go.
I know. I just need a minute to say goodbye.
True.
Hey, we're good. Okay?
Yeah, this is good.
Shit, he's gonna get us all killed. Stay here. Take care of Lily, okay?
I will.
Don't pressure me.
I told you there was something up with this room. It's a goddamn human slaughterhouse.
This seems like a good weapon.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Getting my family back.
What are you gonna do? Walk up and grab his gun?
Good a plan as any.
Oh, fuck me.
It ain't right.
Agreed.
Right. Stay out here all night. I didn't do nothing. They just treat me like I'm some kind of screw up.
All right, time to get your gun.
Dad, what are you doing outside the barn?
Oh, shit.
Just guarding the place, like you said.
Sitting out in the rain, damn weird.
They're talking about killing us.
Can't keep that many folks alive and not expect trouble. Pick one to keep and kill.
We'll take him out together.
How?
He doesn't know we're out. He's got to walk past us to get to the bunker. We can take him out when his back is to us. See what he's doing now.
Oh, I know, Mabel. This is my favorite part, too. When I let one think they can just walk right out.
Hey, tell me something.
Shut up, Kenny. I'm focusing.
He's inside. He's not coming any closer.
See where he is now.
Where is he?
What the?
Sick fucker thinks this is a game.
See where he is now.
I don't see him anymore.
Where the fuck did he go?
I don't know.
Look again. He didn't go past us. See where he is now.
Shut up, Kenny. I know what I have to. Oh, like hell you are. Get killed. Kenny, you mother. Lily. Go, just go. Bruh. What?
You see? You understand now, don't you? You can have me. It's how the world works now. Get part of yourself so others can live.
I should fucking kill you right now.
Yeah, I should. Wait, that's why you killed the woman. Yeah, that's why you killed the woman, you son of a bitch.
That's why you killed that woman in the woods. She was about to spill everything.
You weren't ready to hear yet, Lee. Had to stop her. You gotta keep me alive. If you kill me, the meat gets tainted. You can't eat it.
You're already tainted.
You ain't gonna kill me. Just like he didn't kill Jolene. You don't have what it takes. Fucking coward.
Fuck you, I am just gonna leave you to die here.
This is not how the world works now. You won't make me kill you!
I'm just gonna leave him to die, guys. Don't care if y'all wanna kill him, you can kill him in your own playthrough. I'm just gonna leave him to die. He's already gonna die. They have no release hatch.
Go. I'll cover you.
Just stay here and keep Clementine safe. Be right back.
I have to teach Clementine. Only kill when necessary. If they're already gonna die, don't kill them. Just let them suffer.
Kenny!
Too long.
You think?
They attacked us!
I knew it. I told you we couldn't trust them.
I said it from the very beginning.
Two left.
Where?
Larry's dead. They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed him to us.
Shit.
Is everyone else okay?
They've still got Doc and Kaji in the house, and I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
All right, we're coming in to help.
The main gate is too dangerous. Go around the fence and see if there's a back way in. I'll keep looking for Kenny. Do you have a weapon?
I don't leave home without it. Ben, stick close. And Lee, be careful.
Okay, Coolio 1738. I know that I saved Carly, but you said Farley. You spelled Farley. I know.
I'm a big boy, kick around.
No, I wanted to save Doug. Trust me. I just had a very tough time in that playthrough. I love both characters. They're both cool. Doug is funny and Carly's cool.
Andy? Danny, is that you? What's going on out there?
Oh, let me threaten you.
I left Danny in a bar. He got what he deserved.
Yeah.
Come here. Let me go.
Okay.
Please get back. Don't come in here. You just had to go snooping around, didn't you?
I didn't trust you.
Another step.
Come on now, you know you don't want to do this.
Just go away and leave us be. Stop right there, I mean it.
Think about what you're doing. It doesn't have to end like this.
I'll kill her, Lee. Just let me go.
I just noticed that. No, but if I try being mean to her, I know I'm actually afraid she's gonna get me killed.
Stay back! Don't do anything!
Like, say something stupid? No, you won't. No, I won't. I'm just gonna let that walker do my job for you, so you can end up like one of them. Please, Eater Mark, revenge.
Let him go, goddammit! Oh!
That ain't gonna happen!
Andy, don't!
Shut up!
Ah! Andy, no!
Andy!
Who the fuck do you people think you are? Look at what you've done!
Shut the fuck up!
You think I'm playing here, boy? All we wanted was gas! We came to you peacefully!
You are the reason why everything's going... Okay, time to kill you now. Exactly, Midnight.
Get up! Get the fuck up!
Oh, you will regret that. Come on, I wanna punch you, Andy. No. I can hold this on forever. Come on! No, I can't! I got tired.
Lily!
Help! Oh, you are so screwed up. I'm not gonna stop. This is what you get.
flee. That's enough. He's had enough.
Oh. He hasn't had enough.
Is that all you got, Lee? You ain't shit!
Says the guy with the broken face.
It's over! Fuck you! As soon as Dan and Mama get out here, you all fucked!
Oh, they're both dead.
They're both dead! What did you do? What the fuck did you do? Don't you dare walk away from me, Lee! Get back here and finish this, Lee!
I'm not giving you the benefit of the doubt. I'm not gonna kill you. You can just rot there, knowing that I kicked your ass.
Get back here and fight me like a man, Lee!
Nah.
Lee!
Screw him. Who knows if he comes at me, he's gonna die.
They're getting in!
Oh, he's gonna die.
Lee!
Go.
As the new leader of the group, I say let's go. Well, I just did, viewer. Fight like a dairy farmer.
Hey, Lee. I'd say I'm sorry for leaving the motel unattended, but, you know.
I'm glad you showed up when you did. If you hadn't taken that shot at Andy, we might not have gotten out of there.
Were they really killing people? For food?
Yeah, and Clementine almost ate some.
But?
I stopped her. I can't leave her alone, Carly. This fucking world now.
Twitch.
It's hiding just unspeakable shit at every turn.
Katja managed to grab this while she was in the house. She said it was with your stuff.
Yeah. I found it while I was looking for the people who shot Mark. Do you want it?
Why don't you keep it? Sometimes it helps to have something you can document your thoughts on.
How are you doing?
I'll be fine. I'm just not as young as I used to be. Hun, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think?
I'm sorry, Larry, but you murdered Larry.
You murdered Larry.
Fuck you, man. You're alive because of me. Why didn't you have my back?
I saved your wife and kid.
No, I saved them. By making sure Larry didn't kill us.
I couldn't do it, Ken.
Well, maybe we should stay out of each other's way for a while.
Fuck you, Kenny. I saved your frickin' child twice last episode.
Come on, Clementine. Stay close.
Lee, are those bad people dead?
No. They're alive and suffering. They were very bad people. But if they die, it won't be because I killed them.
Okay. Hey, Dad. What's that noise?
What noise?
Sounds like a car.
Oh, God. Not more strangers.
Hello?
Okay, whoever owns this car is a complete idiot. You don't leave the frickin' car open. Much less leave the keys there!
Figures.
Oh, crap! Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
Their car there like that.
This food could save all of us. Not all of us.
Look, we don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours. Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? What if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
I'm siding with Clementine on this one.
You're right. We shouldn't take this.
What? Did you get some meal back there the rest of us missed out on? We have to take this stuff.
Clementine and I don't want any part of this.
We're starving.
Suit yourself.
The rest of us are taking this stuff. Okay, what have we got in here?
Look, there's more food in that box.
They have antibiotics. What else do they have?
See if there's any water.
Here. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Lee, there's a hoodie in here. Could probably fit Clementine.
She's good. Thanks.
Whatever, man. It's gonna get cold out eventually.
Hey, there were some batteries in one of those boxes. I thought they might work in your camcorder. Here, you can have some too. For your walkie-talkie.
Batteries, huh? Think you can handle those?
You're not gonna let me live that down, are you?
Nope. Not having batteries in the radio, then having them backwards.
Oh, God.
Nope.
Lee, you're gonna wanna see this.
Shit.
Not only did I just screw up my group. If I just screw up the only way to get the bandits out of my plate. God damn it. Oh, next time.
This place is done. It's time to move on. Screw it. Not like you ever listen to a damned word I say.
Fuck you, Kenny.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave. Duck was asking about the farm last night. Not much phases. It's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get him out of all this madness. Lily's not doing so good, huh?
You murdered her dad.
I did what I had to, and you know it. Maybe people out there got things lined up better. Better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
Sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else!
Huh, a long road ahead. Let's see, chopping off the guy's leg? Had to. I was trying to save him. Shooting Jolene? Nah. Hoping kill Larry? Oh, actually, that's actually surprising. Half people did, half people didn't. Now that actually is surprising for me. Now, did I kill both brothers? No. I'd rather them get eaten. Stole the food from the car? If I did, I'd be a bad person. Because you don't steal people. We can survive on our own. Sorry. I accidentally clicked the wrong button. But that's it for episode 2. I hope y'all enjoyed it, YouTube and Twitch. This is RonaldoMan99 signing out. I'll see you on episode 3. Peace.